Hello there, future data wizards and decision makers. This is Ananya and I welcome you to our exclusive review series wherein we review topmost business analytics program all across the globe. Today, we'll be taking you through MIT Sloan School of Management's Master in Business Analytics program. We will be giving you its complete review. Should you go for it or not, its class profile, tuition fees, careers, employment report, and whatnot. So let's dive straight into it. Let's start with a little bit of history. All of you are well aware about Massachusetts Institute of Technology, or MIT. Its name is synonymous with successful graduates, cutting-edge technology in business all across the world. Particularly, its business analytics program is offered by MIT Sloan School of Management. This school was founded in 1914 with the goal to keep up with the advancing technology and also use it in management, in business and whatnot to emerge better in this technologically advancing world. And so does its program Business Analytics offer you a chance to solve great business problems using data analytics, machine learning and whatnot. Now let's talk about the rankings. If we go by the QS World Rankings of 2024, right after the UCLA school, we have MIT Sloan School of Management's Business Analytics program on the second number. So has been ranked globally on the second pedestal as per the QS World Rankings, promising you a great and bright future. MIT Sloan School of Management's Data Analytics program is a 12-month doctoral-level STEM-designated program. In this program, you will be learning about advanced data analytics techniques and how does it stand on the intersection of business and analytics with respect to data, statistics, etc. MIT Sloan MSBA is a highly competitive program. As per the 2024 batch, 81 students were admitted, which represent around 65% of international students, which is a diverse pool of students indeed. All these students have a promising at least 15 months of average work experience. So you should have some work experience before you dive into and seek admission in this program, that's for sure. Coming from 29 countries, these students have a promising GPA of 3.9 and their GRE score for quant is at least 168 on an average as per the coming batches. So this elite pool represents a diverse set of students with diverse interests and experiences, and you could be one of them if you show a promising profile to them. Now let's come to the most important part of the video, that is the entry requirements. Now you must be wondering, if one has to be present in this diverse cohort of students, you need to be well versed with the requirements and be good at all of them and submit at least most of them. First comes the resume. Now you're well aware that your resume has to be crisp, short, one page, as per the format listed on the website, as per your various experiences, your internships. Now the resume should be crisp enough for the adcom to go through it, and you should leave a good first impression. As you all know, first impression could be the last impression. Now we come to the essay question. Now in around 500 words or less, you need to make sure that you convince the admission committee that why are you really applying for this program? What do you hope to gain from this program? Are you really interested to pursue this program and specifically why? So in 500 words or less, do answer with utmost honesty without using any such softwares which could get you caught red-handed. Now, there's an interesting component of short answer questions. Here you need to answer from where you really come from, what is your background, your community, and how it has contributed to shape you as a person that you are today. Keep in mind, you need to answer it in a short manner as it is a short answer question, and also you need to establish its relevance to the admission committee as to how this information could be relevant to you being a student pursuing this degree at MIT Sloan and how could you be an asset to the great and known institute. Then there are other few questions as well that are the video questions. You need to have a good camera presence and establish yourself in front of the camera. Be bold and be honest and answer the questions as enlisted. Next, we come to the letter of recommendations. MIT Sloan expects you to submit at least 3 letter of recommendations. It should be really, really confirmed that you are getting recommended from professional sources, those who know you really well and can write well for you, and they will definitely have a say in the admission committee as to why they should really get you in. Next, you need to submit your academic transcripts. Be professional and submit the original transcripts in soft copy and hand in the website as expected. Then you need to establish that you come from a background that can help you and also gain you better momentum in this business analytics and data and business field. So you need to establish that you come from a relevant background and you have done coursework in at least mathematics, statistics, computer programming, etc., so that they can gauge as to how well are you aware with all of these things that you will be learning in great detail in the program later. Next, we come to test scores. GMAT, GRE, etc. are optional, but if you have these scores, definitely submit them. But if you do not have them, you will not be negatively judged. Next, you need to submit a $150 non-refundable admission fees, and if selected, you will be called for an interview. An interview call in itself will be a really good thing to be congratulated upon, but yes, once you're called for the interview, be really confident, be honest, and reflect yourself in person apart from the resume that you really submitted. That was just data. Now, let's talk about numbers. The real thing is the admission fees. So around $91,250 of fees are required to be submitted for this business analytics program to MIT. Now there are other living expenses which may vary according to your individual preferences and tastes. Apart from that, you should be happy enough as the return on investment is really good. In the upcoming part, we learn about the salary and where the individuals have been working. So that would be good news for you. Apart from that, there are numerous scholarships and fellowships offered to you. So you should glance through as per your requirement as to really the scholarships would really help you to get a good return on investment, apart from you being able to apply to this program and learn and evolve better. Now we come to the one of the most compelling aspects of MIT Sloan MSBA or MBAn program, that is its careers and employment report. So as per the employment report of 2022 batch, 100% of the students, yes, you heard that right, 100% of the students were employed within 6 months of their completion of graduation. Now, they were promised and offered an average salary of $135,000, which is a great starting point to get you started, a good momentum for you. And also, additionally, you will be offered a minimum of $48,000 up to $153,000 of average signing bonus, which is an additional gift to you as you've completed your course from such a reputed institution. And it's everyone's dream to work in Amazon, Google, McKinsey and Company, and where not. So all of the graduates have been working in numerous such top tier institutes where you will be working. And there you have it. A deep dive into MIT Sloan or Massachusetts Institute of Technology Sloan School of Management's Master in Business Analytics or MBAn program. Now you know briefly about the program, how it looks like, what are the students like, what have they paid to get it, and now what are they being paid after completing their program. Now stay tuned, as in the next video we will be exploring UCLA's Master in Business Analytics program. Until then, this is Ananya signing off. See you again.